Okay, inshallah, we have Sheikh Yasir Burjass to first address the topic of civic engagement. You all obviously know Sheikh Yasir is the Imam of the Valley Ranch Masjid here in Irving. I don't think we really need to do a thorough introduction. He pretty much self-explanatory. So inshallah, Sheikh, please come on up and get started.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد. So being active in the community is one of the responsibilities that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he had way long before he became a prophet. So that something is not related to being religious or non-religious. It's being a responsible human being, and that's very very important. However, a lot of us, when we come in the Muslim community, specifically under pressure, we would like to be as active as possible. And sometimes we go all the way full force in doing our duty to the society, our civic duty to the society. But there is one more and one much more important duty for each and every one of us that we need to take care of so we can continue with our civic duty. And that is our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here is something I would like to give for the brothers and sisters who would like to become much more active in the community and becoming an activist, or even go out there to, you know, to fuel the civic engagement in their own community. Something I want to warn you against, and that is the actual duty of being so active in that community and in that kind of line of work. It brings with it a sense of loneliness, a sense of loneliness. And I mean by that is the fact that when you are so active out there, there are not so many people probably you will see that share the same values with you. Not so many people they would share the same enthusiasm, the same activism. And as a result, you start feeling lonely, slowly and gradually. And the higher you get with the challenge and the higher you get with the, you know, with your effort and activities, the higher you do that, the much more loneliness you might find yourself as well. And that's why your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes extremely, extremely crucial. That sense of loneliness can only be defeated when you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you and Allah azza wa jal on your side. After all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَالْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. All you who believe, ittaqullah, you fear Allah Azza wa Jal, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدًا. Let every single person or every single soul see what they have sent forth ahead of them. And why is that for? Because that means in each and every one of us, as Allah said as well, وَكُلُّكُمْ آتِيهِ وَكُلُّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. And each and every one of them will come before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala farda, which means alone. And you're going to be questioned about what you've done in this life. So it's very crucial, very important to keep a sound relationship between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. It's very important. And as I'm saying this, because I know the entire conference is all about now changing narratives. We would like our brothers and sisters to become much more active, much more engaged in the community and in the society. We've been talking to the Muslim community to go and register to vote. We want them to go out there and be there in the public. Make sure that they speak and they talk. We want everybody to be there visible. Their duties as Muslims towards their own selves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their community and the entire society is very crucial, specifically in this election, this year basically for us, for all of us. But in the process, a lot of us, they kind of like become heedless of their own personal duty with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Getting too far out there might weaken your own relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unless you always keep Allah Azza wa Jal on your side. How did this happen anyway? There's so many mistakes people do when they go out there in activism. When you go into civic engagement and you deal with people of different faiths, people of different ideologies, people of different lifestyles, you know, you're gonna have to make a lot of compromises. And that is obviously understood, as long as it's something very well planned and very well organized. But here's a message that Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala, just to give you an idea how crucial that is. Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala became the Khalifa of the Muslimin at some point. He became the Khalifa. You know, being basically the leader of the Muslim Ummah. Can you imagine the highest official position in the Islamic State? That was Muawiyah Abu Sufyan radiallahu ta'ala. So if he wants to do anything, he could do it. If anyone needs friends, needs company, needs people around him, would be the head of the state. He can call anyone and they would be honored to be around him. But Muawiyah, even as a leader, he wasn't entertaining that. So guess what he did? He sent a message to Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. He sent a message to Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha. Qala ya Umm al-Mu'mineen, uktubi li kitaban, tuusini fihi wa la tukthiri alayhi. He said to her, he just wrote to her a message, short message. Like you could say like a text message back then, but it takes months to get there and back. So he sent her a text message where someone says, Ya Umm al-Mu'mineen, O Mother of the Believers. He asked a very simple question. He says, Uktubi li kitaban, please send me a message, send me a letter. And I want you to give me a wasiyah, give me a nasiha, advise me. Wala tukthiri alayhi, and don't make it too much. Like obviously, you know, he's too busy dealing with the ummah, Muslims, non-Muslims, the state and the interior affairs, external affairs, all these kind of things and so on. Still, he needed that wasiyah, that advice from Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha radiallahu anha. And he needed to be very short and most powerful. So what did he tell him? She said to him, قالت إلى معاوية سلام عليك. To Muawiyah, peace be with you. قالت فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. She gave him a very simple message and straight to the point in regard to dealing with people, engaging with people. She said to him, قالت سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول. I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, من التمس رضاء الله بسخط الناس كفاه الله مؤونة الناس ومن التمس رضاء الناس بسخط الله وكله الله إلى الناس رواه الترمذي. She said to him that I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم one time saying, من التمس رضاء الله بسخط الناس. Whoever pursued, whoever looked for رضاء الله, to please Allah سبحانه وتعالى, even if that entails people will be displeased with him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of the people for him. Which means as long as you please Allah azza wa jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the people around. Allah will bring them around for you. And then she said again, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ إِلْتَمَسَ رِضَاءَ النَّاسِ بِسَخَطِ اللَّهِ. And whoever sought to please the people, even if this is going to entail that he will displease Allah azza wa jal, قَالَ وَكَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَى النَّاسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will delegate his affairs to the people. Like, deal with them. What do we mean by that? I mean by this, but whenever we go out there and try to be active in the community, we do so much. And in our intention, we do it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And there is nothing wrong with that. But our biggest issue is that we go so much so in compromising so that we come too close to the people that we go far away from the central point. And that is the point of why we're doing this for in the first place. We're supposed to be doing this for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. But now we start making so many compromises that we lose the point of reference. Sheikh Omar mentioned that in the khatat he gave after Salat al-Maghrib right now. We said that Allah subhanahu left for us the Quran and the Sunnah that we refer back to. So if we have any confusion, if we have any dispute over anything, we go back again to these usul, these principles. Otherwise we go astray. So if we're going to now argue if this is a good way of doing it, should we approach the people in that fashion? What about having this kind of alliance? What about this kind of, you know, activity? Whatever we're going to be doing in our civic engagement has to go back again to pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that's something I want my dear brothers and sisters to pay attention to. You know, a lot of us, we fail in our interpersonal relationships, whether it's with your spouse, with your friends, with your colleagues and so on. Why is that? Because we put so much emphasis in trying to strengthen the relationship with the people, but we weaken the relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal. So we give up so much of our rights and our rights towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obligation towards Allah Azza wa Jal to please other people. And because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet says, وَكَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَى النَّاسِ, Allah will leave you to the people. You get your reward from them then. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned Sahih al-Bukhari in Hadith Jibreel, Hadith Jibreel alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا نَادَى جِبْرِيلٌ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves somebody, when Allah azza wa jal loves someone, نَادَى جِبْرِيلٌ, He will call Jibreel. And Jibreel is responding to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's call. He hears now the command from Allah, يَا جِبْرِيلْ إِنِّي أُحِبُّ فُلَانًا فَأَحِبَّهُ. Jibreel, I love this person. So immediately Jibreel, for the love of Allah subhanahu for this person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that love for this man or this woman in the heart of Jibreel. So Jibreel loved this person. And Jibreel, he doesn't keep it for himself. He goes straight to the people of the heavens. إِنَّ اللَّهِ يُحِبُّ فُلَانًا. Allah loved this person. فَأَحِبُّوهُ فَيُحِبُّوا أَهْلُ السَّمَاءِ. All in the inhabitants of the heavens will love this person. ثُمَّ يُجْعَلُ لَهُ الْقَبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And then that love and that satisfaction will be put for him or her on earth. Which means Allah Azza wa Jal will turn the hearts of the people to love this individual. You know Musa alayhi salam, he was in danger. He was in the greatest danger you can even think of. The plan is that you keep your son with you, that was told to the mother of Musa alayhi salam, keep him with you. فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ فَأَلْقِهِ فِي الْيَمِّ. When you're so afraid for him, throw him in the water. وَلَا تَخَافِ. Don't worry about him. We'll take care of him from there. Allah took care of him from there. Even though the mother, she trusted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, she put the baby on the surface of the water, but she asked his sister to go and follow him. قُصِّي. Go after him. See what is, what's going to happen to him. He ends up in the hand of the man he's supposed to escape in the first place. But there was a secret there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Musa alayhi salam, وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي. And I have thrown that love for you in the heart of people. Remember, Allah Azza wa Jal, He is the one who softened the hearts of the wife of the Pharaoh in the first place. The people who were there, Allah softened their hearts to love Musa alayhi salam, so he was accepted as one of them and he grew up in their own household. In an unamazing turn of events in their life, subhanAllah. And that is can happen to each and every one of us in the same fashion. You know, sometimes even subhanAllah, real life, you have some babies, when you look at them, you look at these babies, you say, they're very adorable. They don't even talk, they're just babies. They look at you, you look at them, you say, you fall in love with them. MashaAllah, so adorable, so sweet, so beautiful. Other babies, you look at them and you say, Allah musta'an. You don't know how they're gonna turn out, you know, when they grow older. Musa alayhi salam was one of those adorable babies. When they picked him up, the first thing, they just fell in love with him. How could this happen? Without the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hearts of the people are in the hand of Allah azza wa jal, not in my hand, not in your hand. As much as you try in your civic engagement activities and duties and so on, as much as you try, if you don't put your trust back in Allah azza wa jal to help you with the people, your effort might be actually so tiring, I might not get the result that you expect or you're hoping to get. So make sure that instead of worrying about, you know, pleasing the people in such an event that you're making, or such a conversation you're taking, or a debate, or a dialogue, or whatever that you're making in order to, you know, bring alliance and come closer to the people, regardless how much you try, you need to make your focus to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, how do I do that? For the people who go into activism a lot, you know what, there would be no enough time for you even to do your 5 daily prayers sometimes. You're always on the road. You combine the salawat and because you're extremely tired, your salah is the shortest you can think of. When is it going to be that you're going to pray a salah that you'll be pleased with, you'll be satisfied with? You know what, tell me about it. I travel a lot. I know what it means to be on the road. Even the Prophet ﷺ said, As-safar qut'atu min al-adab. Safar can be like a piece of torment, like a torture. It prevents you from eating well, from drinking well, from sleeping well. It interrupts all your activities. If you're going to be active in the community, probably you're going to spend so much time doing that. You're going to need a very solid heart, a strong iman, and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the love for the work that you do for the sake of Allah azza wa jal. Otherwise, at some point, you're going to get tired. So what do I need to do then? The instruction came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran, and to me and you. When Allah Azza wa Jal spoke to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Surah Al-Sharh, we all know this surah probably because it's one of the shortest surah in the Quran. Allah said to him, قَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَى رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ. When you're done with your work, What kind of work he was doing, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He wasn't selling anything, he was selling them Jannah. He was guiding people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isn't that what is the core of our values when we go out to reach out to people? We would like to build, inshallah, a good alliance, good relationship with the people. Hopefully they will see, inshallah, the nur and the khair. And here's the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spending so much time out there for the community in Mecca, day and night. And when he's done from all of this work for the sake of Allah, for the da'wah, what was the instruction that was given to him? You expect after spending many hours speaking and talking and going, running around and so on, that someone will tell you what? When you're done dealing with the people, go get some rest. No, that wasn't what the Prophet ﷺ was told. Allah says, fansab. Fansab, which means go ahead and put yourself into devotion until you feel the fatigue, until you get tired and exhausted. Why is that? That's an upgrade in your iman, so that you don't forget that what you're doing is supposed to be for this, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for these brothers and sisters who are going to be, inshallah, that are engaging soon with their communities, when you become very active, I want you to remember this. If Allah azza wa jalla loves you, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with you, He will make the entire universe to conspire for your own benefit. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not pleased with you, regardless how much you try, no money, no eloquence of speech, no effort, no image, no compromise you can make that will make the people happy with you or pleased with you. This is a valuable lesson to all of us. As we move on in this community, we see the pressure that's coming around us. Especially here in Irvine, you guys know that very well, more than anybody else. The election is coming very soon, and even not just the presidential election, even the city and mayoral elections is coming. And that is going to be a crucial time for us here. So as we go out there to engage in the civic engagement duty that we have in our community, I don't want you to forget about the most important and most valuable relationship. The relationship is not with the people, it's with the Lord of the people, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sure as you go out, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to invite people to Allah azza wa jal, you take your share. You take your share from this devotion. Put yourself to the fatigue during the night. Go and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And during the day, do some extra work for yourself, for the sake of Allah azza wa jal. It's not always about serving the people. It's also making sure that you keep a sound relationship between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah azza wa jal strengthen your iman and your heart, ya Rabbil Alameen. And I ask Allah to give us the ability to please Him in everything that we do, in everything that we say. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Next up to speak will be Ustad Noman.